Good afternoon. Welcome. I love having this group here. I almost feel like they're our house band. And they come in and act like they're our house band, so that works out well all the way around. I wanted to let you know that our gift shop is open for afterward. There are three ladies over there, if they would be so kind as to stand, so you can know who to look for. Mary, Julianne, Judy, just stand up so people know who to look for. There's a lot of Valentine's stuff in there, and it is, after all, almost Valentine's Day. Thank you. So they'll be open after the service is over. Also, the other thing just slipped my mind. So I will say this, if you will indulge a slightly worried wife and say a little prayer for my husband, because I don't know what's going on at home, but I sent somebody over to see. So he's usually here, and he really wanted to be, but it just wasn't going to happen today. So anyway, I'm looking forward. Every one of these songs are my favorites or close to it, so looking forward to all of it. Go ahead.
We got a little twist on today, if you haven't paid attention to the program. Some vocals. Fortunately, I only get one by me, but by the great Joe Roman, who created the two horns. I usually know who wrote the song that I'm doing, and this one, I don't know. So.
Andy Rather.
But in the spirit of love and Valentine's Day, in my own way, this is one called G-Baby, Ain't I Good to You? Love makes me treat you the way that I do. G-Baby, ain't I good to you? Nothing's too good for a girl so good and true. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? Bought you a fur coat for Christmas, a diamond ring, big Cadillac car, that and that. Love makes me treat you the way that I do. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? Thank you. baby, ain't I good too? Nothing's too good for a girl so good and true. Gee, baby, ain't I good too? Brought you a football for Christmas, a diamond ring, a big Cadillac car, and everything. Love makes me treat you the way that I do. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? Gee, baby, ain't I good to you?
Would you join me, please, in the invitation to celebration? God of love, we confess we are sometimes impatient and often unkind. We are quick to envy and find subtle ways to boast. There are times we are rude and lift ourselves up as we put others down. God of love, we confess that we are quickly angered. We are quick to record how often we've been wronged. There are times we celebrate the misfortune of others. God of love, we confess that we put ourselves first. We're reluctant to give. We are slow to sacrifice. There are times we hesitate to protect. When we are tempted to judge, to assume the worst. When we are tempted to despair, to assume all is lost. When we are tempted to give up, to assume it will never happen. Loving God, teach us to love.
Music trio, sisters of Joe Roma, Dean Cochran, and me, We waste so much energy trying to cover up who we are. When beneath every attitude is the one to be loved, and beneath every anger is a wound to be healed, and beneath every sadness is the fear that there will not be enough time. When we hesitate in being direct, we unknowingly slip something on, some added layer of protection that keeps us from feeling the world. And often, that thin covering is the beginning of a loneliness, which, if not put down, diminishes our chances of joy. It's like wearing gloves every time we touch something, and then forgetting we choose to put them on. We complain that nothing feels quite right. Our challenge each day is not to get dressed to face the world, but to unglove ourselves so that the doorknob feels cold, and the car handle feels wet, and the kiss goodbye feels like the lips of another being, soft and unrepeatable. Join me in the prayer for becoming. Into the warmth of your presence we come, Lord God. Into the warmth of your presence we come, Lord God. Into the warmth of your presence we come, Lord God. Thank you.
words of illumination today are kind of directed toward the women in the audience. No disrespect intended to any man here. But once in a while, you just gotta, when something strikes you, you just gotta use it. Jean Kerr, she was a humorist and a writer back in the 50s, 60s, I think. And she wrote that marrying a man is like buying something you've been admiring for a long time in a shop window. You may love it when you get it home, but it doesn't always go with everything else in the house. Hey, well, what are you going to do?
That's it. I have to follow that.
Hi. I don't know, guys, you might want to, you know. Oh, I was going to talk about love. Oh, well. I like legends. Do you like legends? Not necessarily the only the remarkable kind of NBA legends like Kobe Bryant, God bless his soul. But the legend that comes out of that traditional myth about Valentine's Day, or about Valentine, St. Valentine, you know, it's only 5 days away. Everybody got the cards purchased? Huh? One person? I got a few more. All right. Oh, is it really? Did you hear that? It's her anniversary on Valentine's Day. Lovely. Well, legend has it that Valentine was the patron saint of lovers, epileptics, and beekeepers. How's that for a combination, huh? Yeah, right. And that there were possibly two of them back in the 3rd century. One was a bishop, one was a priest, but they were both martyred. So really, I guess it doesn't make too much difference. And some people think they were really one and the same. So whichever Valentine it was, he had his head cut off on on February 14th. And we celebrated his love. He got his head cut off because he continued to defy Emperor Claudius's decree that he signed a no-marry rule that wouldn't allow single men to marry at that time because he really needed them to go into his army in order to conquer the world. And if you were a married man, I guess you were exempt from the draft or something. Well, Valentine was a priest. He had taken vows, as priestly vows, and he had also, that he was going to convert pagans, but he also took vows that he would marry. And so he did what he thought was the proper thing to do. Well, later on in the Middle Ages, around, 1300, somewhere in there, February 14th became more and more known as a day for lovers to come together. The birds and the bees had become a poetic phrase by then. And in 1381, Chaucer linked romantic love and Valentine's Day when he wrote Parliament of Fowls. Yeah, I'll say a Parliament of Fowls. What it really was is a story about birds and describing how the birds and the animals and plants all come together. Well, maybe, no, I didn't mean it that way. But at that time, they all procreate because winter is over. How am I going to get out of this one? And winter is over and new birth comes to life with the coming of summer. Because back in medieval times, there were only two seasons, summer and winter. There's no spring and there's no fall. So after Valentine's second arrest for disobeying Claudius, he penned a letter to a woman that he had healed of blindness. And the two of them might have fallen in love, for all we know, because at the end of the letter he signed it, from your Valentine. Now that was the humble beginning of what we still do today when we sign our cards, from your Valentine. So inasmuch as his words continue these almost 2,000 years later, Valentine's Day is really only, when you think about it, 1/365th of our year that we really pause to honor love. Yeah, that's nice. But you know, I don't think it's nice enough. Think about what's going on in the world today. You know, just look around you and all in the world outside. And we reflect on love, we have to reflect on the source of all love. We have no alternative when we do that but to conclude that love is more than theological, it is more than physical, it's more than sexual. Love is spiritual. For God so loved the world. Da, da, da. You know the rest. You can finish it. And we act as if love is beyond our human comprehension sometimes. The way we treat each other and the way tweets go flying out about people. We act as if we forget that love is given to us at our birthright. That we're endowed with love at our birthright. And that we're commissioned to live with love, to live in love, and to impart love to others. Not just the one or two or three who are really close to you, but to all others. Even those we don't agree with. 365 days. Out of 365 days each year. Happy Valentine's Day.
Quiet nights of quiet stars, quiet chords from my guitar, floating on the silence that surrounds us. Quiet thoughts and quiet dreams, quiet walks by quiet streams, climbing hills where lovers go to watch the world. Together, we will live eternally in this mood of reverie, away from all the earthly cares around us. My world was dull each minute until I found you in it. Then all at once, the happiness I knew became these quiet nights of loving you. Quiet nights of quiet stars, quiet chords from my guitar, floating on the silence that surrounds us. Quiet thoughts and quiet dreams, quiet walks by quiet stream, climbing hills where lovers go to watch the world below. Together we will live eternally in this mood of reverie, away from all the earthly cares around us. My world was dull each minute until I found you in it. Then all at once, the happiness I knew became these quiet nights of loving you, loving you, loving you.
I didn't, truly. I mean, when have you ever before? Meet the musicians. I don't know if you want to meet each other or you just like to. I like to give that to them because they take it anyway. So.
Still has the rest of his voice. He's got one more song, isn't it? Well, thank you all for being here. And we're always happy when Judy calls us up and asks us to join the Jazz Vespers. It usually happens once, sometimes twice a year. But we're always happy to be here. And we do feel like a house band. And that's a good feeling, because we always feel welcome here. So, to talk about each of the guys in the band briefly, this fellow to my right, I've known him for many, many years. He's a percussionist at the Tri-Cities Opera. He's been in the symphony. He was a teacher at Binghamton University, where he was the percussion instructor there. He owned a drum shop for a long time called Joe's Drum Shop in Johnson City, which later became the Algonquin? No, not the Algonquin. The Arlington Jazz Club, where we had many a great time, which carried on the tradition of the music box and took it to another level. And Joe is currently the percussion instructor at the Burlington Community College, where he teaches a number of drummers there. And he's been a private teacher of percussion, all things percussion, for countless years. 50 years.
Yeah.
Mr. Joe Roma, percussion and vocalist. And to my far left, one of the treasures of Binghamton and Broome County, he is a retired IBMer, but more importantly for me, he has been a mentor and a great resource for level-headedness in the land of jazz here in Broome County. And he's been a mainstay on the piano. And Gene has been one of those guys that has played in many a different band, both the Twilight City Blues Band, which had some notoriety in this area a number of years ago. And then he moved into a group in Pennsylvania where he was doing some touring, and I'll be able to remember the name of that group. The Detonators. And he was doing some touring a little bit far and wide. But he's doing some great work with that band, and he landed himself back here in Binghamton. He's been the mainstay of the Miles Ahead Jazz Quartet, and is now currently the longest running member. member of that group, which we started many, many years ago at the Lost Dog Cafe, where we had a wonderful sort of jazz jam. Gene is an incredible piano player, a great accompanist, and all around incredible person. And it was just his 75th birthday last Wednesday, so would you please put your hands together? And to my immediate left, we have another treasure here. He travels worldwide with NEA Jazz Master Dave Friedman. And besides that, he is bass player for Benny Buckley. And we're very, very fortunate to have Tony here tonight, not because he's a great bass player, but not quite a year ago. But Tony was in a horrific car accident, which broke a number of ribs, along with his left wrist, and a number of other incendiary infirmities. And he worked very, very diligently and very hard to get back to playing bass. And he is a testament to the healing powers of music. And Tony is known sometimes as the anchor of the Dave Friedman group. His travels all over the world. I think of him as the propeller of that group because he really drives that band. If you ever get a chance to check out Dave Friedman, who travels all over the world along with Tony, please do so. He also from Moscow, Pennsylvania, and we are very, very fortunate, very, very blessed to have Tony Marino on bass. Try to stay with the Italian pronunciation. Anyway, I'm just a guy that picked up off the street. I'm originally from Utica, New York. I've taught at Johnson City for many, many years. My career took me to being the coordinator of music at Johnson City Schools. Started teaching at Binghamton University when Al Hahn retired from Binghamton University in 1997. So going on my 22nd year at the university, running the jazz program there with the Harvard Jazz Ensemble. And we've got a concert on April 16th with the great Michael Holliver, who's well known in this area. He's a Grammy-nominated big band writer who writes people all over the world, and actually was the director of the Harvard Jazz Ensemble when Al Hahn was on sabbatical for about 3 years. And he's going to be our guest artist, so please do come and see that. And taught privately in the area, and then play along with a little known group in the area called Splash. We do top 40 music and all kinds of weddings and parties and that kind of stuff. So very, very happy to be here. I'm also a member of the Miles Ahead Jazz Quartet, of which we are today representing. So thank you very much for being here. Thank you, Judy, for keeping these Jazz Vespers going, because without you, we wouldn't have them. Without them, we wouldn't have us. So thank you very, very much.
Mike Kerbal. Well, as I say every month and mean it every month, thank you for supporting us. Thank you for showing up. I know it's not a warm day out there, but you make it warm in here. And we appreciate your support, both your presence and your monetary support. So thank you again.
Rock.
all right. Before we do this, a couple of disclaimers. First, this was his idea. Second, Michael said to me earlier, and it's true, everybody wants to sing with a band.
Oh.
But in this case, it's going to be Gene who helps us out in the key of D or thereabouts, actually. We're not fussy over here. And, yep. It's about old age, I know nothing. May locks and nose drops and needles for knitting. Walkers and handrails and new dental fittings. Bundles of magazines tied up with string. These are a few of my favorite things.
Cadillacs, cataracts, hearing aids, glasses, Polident, Fixident, false teeth and glasses. Pacemakers, golf carts, and porches with swings. These are a few of my favorite things.
When the pipes leak.
When the bones creak.
When the knees go bad.
I simply remember my favorite things. And then I don't feel so.
Hot tea and crumpets and corn pads for bunions. No spicy hot food or food cooked with onions. Bathrobes and heating pads, hot meals they bring. These are a few of my favorite things.
Back pains, confused brains, and no fear of sinning. More bones and fractures and hair that is thinning. More of the pleasures advancing age brings. When we remember our favorite things.
When the joints ache, when the hips break,
when the eyes grow dim.
I simply remember the great life I've had. And then I don't feel so.
Gentlemen, that was very nice. You covered us up very nicely, and I appreciate that. Yeah, well. Next month, we'll be Cookie Coogan and Friends. And Bob's groaning because he's going to be out of town, but you can't catch them all, honey. And again, my deepest thanks to these gentlemen. They are so good, and it's such a pleasure to listen to you. I could extend it for half an hour, but... In the meantime, I want to hear Joe sing again.
L for the way you look at me. O for the only one. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. It's all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Make it, take my heart, please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Thank you. for the only one I see. B is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore. Again, love is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart, please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you.
Carbone, Joe Roma, Tony Marino, Gene Coughlin.
Thank you very, very much. If you'd like to know where we're going a long time, we have a website. It's milesaheadjazz.net. Or if you're a Facebooker, we're on the Miles Ahead Jazz Quartet. In the meantime, be good to yourselves, be kind to each other. Don't be afraid to snap your fingers when you're out having a walk. And always keep a song in your heart. Good night.